Hello and welcome to Indus News. My name is Hamza Amjad, coming to you from our studios in Lahore. These are the top stories of this hour. Pakistan has urged the Taliban to talk to the Afghan government in order to reach a political settlement. In an interview, Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi said that outsiders cannot help Afghanistan if Taliban and Kabul don't talk. Peace talks between Taliban and the US have been called off because the insurgents refused to meet Kabul's representatives. Moving on, government forces have shelled an opposition-controlled zone in northern Syria, breaking a four-month truce negotiated by Turkey and Syria. War monitors said that government forces attacked parts of Aleppo, Idlib, Hama and Latakia provinces. The government attacks were the first since an extremist militia seized most of the truce zone along Turkey's border. Meanwhile, the US-led coalition in Syria has started to withdraw its forces and equipment. Coalition spokesman Sean Ryan said specific timelines of the withdrawal would not be revealed. Despite the announcement, Russia expressed doubts that US forces will leave Syria. In another development, British Foreign Secretary Jeremy Hunt has said that Brexit might not happen. Hunt said that there was a real chance that Britain will not leave the European Union if Parliament again votes down the government's deal. Parliament is scheduled to vote on January the 15th. Brexit campaign's two biggest donors, Peter Hargreaves and Crispin Odey, also said that they do not see Britain leaving the EU. To space, where a Chinese spacecraft has taken panoramic photos of the dark side of the moon. The 360-degree photos taken by the Chang'e 4 spacecraft will be used to study the moon's geology. They were relayed back to Earth via a satellite operating more than 450,000 kilometers away. That was all for the moment. Thank you for watching Indus News. Stay with us.